there were lullabies and love songs, traditional folk songs of life on the island of Cyprus, sung by Fulbright scholar Nicoleta Dimitriou. And they highlighted the first evening of the Modern Greek Studies Symposium held in Atlantic City this weekend.
I'll be performing some Cypriot folk songs, the traditional songs from Cyprus. Most of them are love songs. So these are songs that are usually performed with the violin and the lauto at home. But here we thought we'd experiment a little bit, and so I'm collaborating with an Armenian-American oud player. And so we have our own kind of variations of the songs.
Is there a variation between what we would hear as traditional music in Greece versus Cyprus or other surrounding countries?
There are both similarities and differences. Of course, Cyprus has been influenced not only by the music of Greece, but also by the music of Asia Minor. So we have a lot of influences from that area, and also by the music of Turkey and other surrounding neighboring countries. So yes, some tunes are quite similar, certain rhythms, some dances are similar, but there are also quite a few differences.
The biannual event was hosted by the Pappas Center for Hellenic Studies at Stockton University. Professors David Rossell and Tom Papadimitriou, director of the center, co-chaired the four-day program that kicked off on Thursday with an awards reception.
We have a very active Greek community around campus. We have an interdisciplinary center on campus. We have a lot of exchanges with Greek universities and Cypriot universities. So this was like a no-brainer for us to extend ourselves to host this conference. We're really happy to have it here. It makes perfect sense for us.
You also mentioned inside that when the students come back from a journey abroad, they come back changed. Could we talk about that a little bit?
Sure. They go to Greece. A lot of them have never even thought of traveling. They don't have the means to travel. And when they're able to do so, and they go to Greece, and they see sort of history in the midst of a modern city, they see monuments, and they're blown away, and they come back. And we had one student, Megan Coates, who went to Thessaloniki and came back and did a series of realistic paintings of monuments and street scenes in Thessaloniki. And she actually has helped organize this conference as well.
The MGSA is a scholarly organization. We were created 50 years ago, well, in 1968, by a small group of scholars who met in New York at the New York Hilton Hotel. They decided they wanted an organization to promote modern Greek studies in North America. And so we see that as our goal. It's the promotion of modern Greek studies, the establishment of modern Greek programs throughout the country.
Where do these programs take place and how often do they take place?
Well, the programs are programs that offer modern Greek classes, courses on language and culture, the history, sociology, the humanities, and these programs exist in many universities throughout the country. As an association, we meet every 2 years where we hold a symposium, as this symposium here, the one we're at, and we bring in scholars from all over the world. It's truly international. Scholars come in from throughout the world and they present their research on any aspect of modern Greek scholarship that they are doing.
This the Modern Greek Studies Association was started by that gentleman over there 50 years ago, basically. And it's just a wonderful meeting of scholars and people interested in promoting our ancient culture as it is manifest in today's world. So we're strong supporters of them. I'm glad to be here. A lot of these people have become our friends. A lot of academicians lack some business sense, and hopefully we can provide some of that to basically bring them together to make what they do relevant to all of us and to the mainstream. So really excited to be here and to be supporters. And I've spoken too much.
This organization started during the Greek dictatorship. And at the time, there were very few of us who were interested And a friend of mine said, look, it only took three members of the strategic forces of Greece to create a dictatorship. There are two of us here. Let's grab a third, and we can create a new Modern Greek Studies Association. I'm only half joking. The next day, five of us got together and put down $5 each. And according to this gentleman who was, he said, you be president and I'll be secretary and I'll arrange for the stationery. We'll go out and buy it now and we'll set up a committee and we'll send out notices that we're going to start a Modern Greek Studies Association and we'll see what happens. And we did, and that's how it started.
How has this organization grown and evolved? Can we briefly get that?
Well, we were lucky because the first time we met at Princeton University where I got a grant from the, one of the grant-giving associations that support things. I can't quite remember which one it was. They gave us enough money to invite some people from Greece, and we had a very good symposium there, the very first symposium, of which this is the 25th. And it was so good that we collected the essays from that symposium, and it was published by Princeton University Press as a volume called Modern Greek Writers, the first volume in this country to honor the modern Greek writers. And that was how our association got authority right away. And from then on, we met every other year with these symposia, including one at Harvard during the dictatorship where we got up and challenged the dictatorship at a distance. The Greek American community was more in favor of it than we were, we intellectuals, so-called. Anyway, that was the beginning, and it was a very small organization initially, but it has picked up, and of course, at that time, modern Greek as a subject was taught in very few places. I had to sneak it into my curriculum at Princeton even. Now it's taught in many universities. There are a lot of universities that have some courses in modern Greek, and of course the association is much larger, so I don't know how many members, it's got over 500. And that's partly because interest in modern Greek expanded with two Nobel Prize winners in literature, Elitis and Seferis. Seferis and Elitis, let's put them in proper order.
I am an American-American, married to a Greek woman for 20-some years now, and I started becoming interested in modern Greek studies as a graduate student. I was doing a PhD in American studies. I started traveling to Greece with my future wife, became very interested in the culture, not in the ancient culture, in the modern culture, and particularly in, I was interested in popular culture. I wound up learning Greek, teaching myself Greek, and wrote my dissertation on the influence of American television on Greek culture.
Fascinating. Give us an idea about your position here this weekend.
So this weekend I am one of the co-chairs of the program committee. The program committee is charged with evaluating the abstracts that are submitted, sending out the call for papers, of course, before that, and then putting together the program, putting the different papers together on panels, and trying to organize things so that it'll have good intellectual interactions and cross currents that are fertilizing thought and also make everyone who's presenting happy.
My artwork is based off of landscapes that I saw when I visited twice, once in January and once in May. I'll be going back in December, so maybe I'll have more, you know, when I return, who knows. They're basically different landscapes of structures and ruins, things that really captured my imagination, things that really made me feel unburdened. Like there's a feeling, you know, when you're a minority living in the United States, you know, and when you leave the United States, that feeling is just gone. And it's something that I just wish that everyone could experience. You know, it's just a wonderful feeling. And I just hope that my paintings captured that feeling that I got when I was there.
A particular favorite or particular image that you've created you could talk about?
My particular favorite, I call it Salonika. It's a painting of Thessaloniki. We were walking up to a monastery up this very steep hill, and I can remember just turning and looking and just seeing the beautiful city and the harbor and the ocean beyond it and just the Mediterranean. It was beautiful. And that to me, that is my favorite painting because it captures exactly how I felt at that moment. So that's my favorite one.